salute the spirit of this august house, which has weaved an anthem of togetherness, showing solidarity with our people in distress in Tamil Nadu, Andhra, and other parts. So inspiring is this move, and equally inspiring is the way that our people, the brave people, the courageous people in distress in Chennai and other parts, who are, in spite of being in distress and great difficulty, they are trying to help each other. And why not? In the Nerukkari, Nerukkari, Desam Munavadam, Tamil Sahodara Sahodrigal, Pakkam Nerukkari. So, we stand in this hour of crisis, and the entire nation stands with Tamil sisters and brothers, and wherever the rains have brought havoc. This is a very difficult situation. We are speaking here, we are communicating with each other, and after that we will go back home and have hot meals and look at the screens that how the disaster has brought havoc in Tamil Nadu. But when we feel about our people in Tamil Nadu, the hot meals leave aside. It's impossible to communicate with each other. It's very difficult to know what's going to happen tomorrow, who is going to help them, and what kind of help will be brought to them. I thank our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, who has immediately sanctioned 949 crores for the disaster relief, 39, whatever, plus 900 crores, and today 500 plus crores have already been released. We all stand today with the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. All support is given to them, and I was deeply moved with the speech Honorable Kanimori gave, and especially the example of those family members of four member family that simply washed away. It reminded me of Kedarnath tragedy, where the people had seen their sisters, brothers, son, daughter, husband being washed away in the floods before their eyes, and they kept on coming to Chamoli, Joshima, then in those areas, after 2 years, after 3 years, in faint hope, maybe they will find their peers and dear ones alive there. That kind of a situation is very difficult for us to feel and realize. Therefore, this August house has given a very strong message of the spirit of India to our people in distress, and that goes very well with the message of Thiruvalluvar. A friend in need is a friend indeed. That is what Thirukkural has said. Sir, the kind of disaster that we see, but I must say that today itself, we must decide about providing help from ambulance. I humbly announce that from my ambulance funds, I will give 50 lakhs rupees for the Tamil Nadu disaster relief. And I'm sure that my honorable leaders and my colleagues, they will be more forthright and they will give more inspiration by announcing such a help. This is just a symbolic. This is nothing much, but it is a gesture that in the hour of difficulty, in the hour of distress, we stand with you. The other thing is that how the role of social media in this distress, anonymous, wherever they are able to open internet and go on social media on tweets, we are finding help Chennai Rains affected people, help to affected people. I was just looking at my site, hot meals and shelter available on this road. Call us on this number. We salute the people of Chennai who are providing common people, anonymous people. We will never be able to know about them, but they are coming out of the houses and providing the best help they can give. And whatever they have in their houses, they are sharing it with others. They inspire us. They give inspiration to every one of us, and especially those where we still have to find such doctors. Doctors are giving their numbers. If you need any help, even if you cannot come to me, please call me if you can. I will advise you. on telephone. The common people are coming out, especially as Honorable Member also said in her speech. We salute the soldiers of our army and navy. They have given great help. Always they have given, even in Uttarakhand, they were the they were hands of angels, like gods. And they have given help to people in distress, and we salute them. They have put their own life in risk and still help them. So, I would like to point out one thing. Let this be taken as a lesson also. No blame game, but can we form a people's movement for better water management? Let this be a people's agenda. Desilting of the rivers and deepening of the channels can control aggravating such situation in such disastrous conditions. Secondly, as one architect, Javier Benedict has said, that revisiting the principles of traditional architecture is another solution. Benedict says, traditional homes in Tamil Nadu villages have raised plinths, and all the streets used to be aligned with temple tanks and ponds. It is unfortunate that with modern education systems being inspired solely by the West, we have forgotten localized design principles in architecture and engineering. Can we revisit this? Can we review such things? And like the South Buckingham Canal from Adyar Creek to Kovalam Creek has been reduced in many places to make way for several projects. Can we review this kind of a thing so that the rivers are desilted and channels are deepened? The Kuom River, for instance, has been a topic of discussion for years, and bringing back its pristine charm is an uphill but achievable task. Let the togetherness that Parliament has shown today be also reflected in our togetherness in Tamil Nadu and Chennai. Let all of us work together and have a people's moment for a better water management. Thank you, sir.